My name's Eric Strebel, and welcome to another video of mine about industrial design.
This is the second video in my Adventure Toy Rendering series.
You're looking at the Red Jack Adventure Toy Vehicle.
In my previous video, I showed you how I thumbnail concepted the ideas for the Red Jack. In this video, we're going to take a look at how the marker rendering is done. So, for any good rendering, you want to have a really good foundation or a good underlay. In this case, I start with a little 3D model underlay of the wheels and a box, and then I sketch on top of that. When you're designing a product, it doesn't matter if it's a toaster, a toy, or a car, getting the perspective right and drawing it inside of a box is a super easy, straightforward way to go about constructing your view. So in this case, I lay in the vehicle and I make a huge change right here. I don't like the roof line, the proportions are too high, so I just lower it. I like the proportions so much better of this view, and I'm just going with the flow, laying everything out. And you'll notice I'm using a pencil, and the pencil allows me to basically rough everything in. So if I don't like it, I can erase it, change it. And then later on, when I do all the markers and everything, I don't have to worry about messing anything up, because I've already done it in pencil, and it gives me lots of flexibility. Just using a super basic pencil, laying in the shadows here, straight down shadow from the top. It's not actually perfectly correct. I do add a little bit of an angled shadow for the roof, doing the rest of the details here. Now I'm going in, working out the wheels, and getting those right. When you're designing any sort of a wheeled vehicle, it's super extraordinarily important to get the perspective and the ellipses correct on the wheels, because if those don't read right, no matter how good your rendering is, the whole thing won't be believable. Now, I've got the perspective down to where I want. I'm done with my basic line drawing, and I'm going to go and start with the markers. I use a brown for the wheels, and I do the wheels first so that in case I happen to screw up the wheels, I can just scrap the drawing at this point versus doing the wheels at the end. If I screw up the wheels at the end, then the whole, I've wasted all that time. So I make sure I get the wheels right, and I can tell in the very early stages that the wheels are good and I can move on. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to add a ground plane shadow. And I'm going to do this in a light blue color. It's a little bit of an unusual color to use, but I want the vehicle to look like it's sitting outside, maybe in the snow or on an ice, sheet of ice, something like that. You'll also notice that I've erased a lot of the shadow lines that I did in pencil, and it's only very lightly there. I really dislike when shadows are outlined, so I try to erase most of that. I come in with a medium value blue, and then a darker blue under the very vehicle itself, and come back with that medium blue to try to blend everything together so it looks natural. Next, I'm going to add some value to the body of the vehicle. It's got a stamped metal lower with some ridges in it. The light is coming from the top right of the page. So stuff on the right-hand side is going to be a little bit lighter, and as the light wraps around the vehicle, stuff on the left is going to be a little bit darker value. You can see that in the lower and in the upper glass that I'm doing right there. A little bit darker as stuff wraps and moves away from us. Now I'm going to move on to the upper. So the upper has that little roof line, a little overhang, and the doors and the windows, and I'm working on all of those details to make sure that they're right and believable. Add a little bit more contrast and darker value gray to the bottom there so that I can show the surface wrapping around the back a little bit more. Just laying in some of the details and now some of the color that really makes the whole vehicle kind of pop. It's the Red Jack after all, so it has red details, the door, the roof line, little architectural details. Now I'm going to work on some of the important things like shadows, adding in some darker contrast to make things punchier and read a little bit better. I'm doing that under the vehicle to anchor it to the ground a little bit more. Some of the shadows underneath the roof line. And here the glass gets a little bit darker, so it has a little bit more of a transparency. Underneath the fender, I'm going to add a little bit of value here so that it looks like it has some depth, and add some to the roof so it looks like the surfaces change, and adding in some highlights to show some of the details so those don't get lost. I hope you enjoyed this video. In the next episode, we're going to take a look at a three-quarter top-down view, and in that episode, we're going to take a little bit more detailed look at actually creating the perspective underlay of that vehicle to give you a little bit better idea of how you set up a rendering like this. If you like the music in this video, head on over to Mike's website, hunchbunny.com, give him a shout out, let him know that you like it. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube page. You can also follow me on Twitter and Facebook. Thanks. Rock on.